my beloved.
Now, you could probably guess from that intro, I really like the MF-11. And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do I love the MF-11? I mean, weapons and stuff told me it was a bad Chinese mask. So, basically, why does this sexy lad like the MF-11 so much? It's pretty weird. Now you're probably thinking, Chase hasn't posted in ages and now he's talking about Chinese masks. Is it because I accidentally said Taiwan is a country and now I'm deducted like billions of social credit points? Perhaps it is. Perhaps I'm trying to save myself from being ass-raped by Xi Jinping's men. Well, yeah, that's a part of it, but at the same time, I do genuinely like the MF-11. There's a very bad stigma around Chinese masks, because of course they're made in China, that they're pretty bad, when in reality that is not the truth. Chinese masks are surprisingly quite high quality. Now, when you think of China, a few things come to mind. There's the food, you know, there's the people, and there's also that one What you don't think about, however, is the gas masks. Which is literally the whole point of this video, so I think I'm done with the jokes and I'll actually get into the video now. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. And am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck? Now, the overall idea of the pros and cons is basically you take the positives and the negatives of the item and you compare them and see if it's worth its weight in its usefulness. Now, this is what I'm going to use to basically explain my point of the mask actually being decent. Now, pro one is its flexibility. It doesn't feel too clunky, doesn't feel too big, and overall it is just really convenient to carry around in a bag or just carry around by hand, to be honest. Pro two has to be its simplicity. As you can see, it is a very simple mask with not much going on. However, where it's simple is its greatest features. And as you can see, if you take that off, you can actually take off the exhale valve itself and you can just place it right back in and screw it on. And unlike other simple masks, this one's actually half decent. Another pro is how easy the straps are to adjust. If you want to loosen them, you just kind of like hold this part here and you just stretch and wind it through like that. And if you want to make them tighter, it's just simple as a quick pull. Another pro is also the very good visibility you get through it. As you can see, it is quite a good mask that you can see through very easily and it doesn't feel that restrictive on your vision. Another positive as well is although it doesn't really have a proper voice diaphragm, you can hear me quite well because the exhale valve is big enough to make it easier for me to speak through. And as you can see, the mask also doesn't fog up, so that's really convenient. Also, I forgot to mention when I was wearing the mask, but it's also quite breathable. I haven't actually got a Chinese filter, and of course I don't want to ruin the thread, so I'm not going to put a filter on it, but without a filter, it is quite breathable. And I'll say the final pro with it is that the rubber is actually very, very high quality. That it is, it's quite thick rubber, as you can see there, but it isn't like too restrictive type of thick. It is very flexible, as I said in the earlier points, and as well as that, it does feel quite comfy to wear. So that will be the final pro. And so far, this is what we got. It is flexible, it's simple, the straps are easy to adjust, so there's a good field of view, your voice is very clear for it, it is breathable, and the rubber is very high quality. Now let's get into the cons. Now, one of the major cons with the MF-11, which stops it from being really the perfect mask, is actually, if you have a look at here, there's a slight hole here, and there's no actual way to defog the lenses. So, say that you're sweating and you start fogging up a bit, there's no actual way to defog the mask. It just stops you from fogging up through your breath. Another con is that really sometimes it doesn't fit your face the best. However, I will give it a pass because it was meant for built Chinese men and not chubby little Welsh boys. So I think that really is the only con, that is sometimes is not fully defogged despite having an oral nasal cup. Now, overall, this is what we got, and you can see that really its only con is that there's no way to defog it once it's fogged. And that's why, overall, the mask I can not recommend highly enough. It is a really good gas mask, and I'd highly advise you get it, especially from Only Army Surplus, who are selling them for a reasonable price, at least for the UK, of £45 each. And now it's time to conclude the video overall with basically the facts and information about the mask I've talked about so much, the lovely jubbly Chinese MF-11. The MF-11, also known as the FMJ-05, is China's current standard issue protective mask. The MF-11 made by Tangshan Puda, I hope I pronounced that correctly, is currently used by the Chinese People's Liberation Army in small numbers, as well as for use among civilians working in areas such as industry, agriculture, and scientific research. The mask itself is made out of black rubber and a filter that comes with a mask. Designated the ZBR2V filter, provides protection against CBR and threats. The mask features a rounded triangular eye lens. Other variants of this mask feature eye lenses that are similar to the FM12 gas mask. The mask uses a 6-point head harness that is either made with elastic, which is the military version, or rubber strap, which is the civilian version. The military version is made by, I'll put that on the screen now because I can't pronounce that, while the civilian version, which is mine, was made by Tangshan Puda. I really hope I'm pronouncing that correctly.
For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has.